Hi, good morning. How are you all? Good morning, Akshara. Good morning, Abhigna. Pooja, Akshara again. How about you? I'm fine here. You're all very good. That's nice. Okay, good morning. Yeah, Chandana is saying good morning, good morning. Akshara, Abhigna. Okay, Ravi Surya, good morning. Happy morning, dear. Happy morning. Tabasum is saying good morning, good morning. So, we are going to start again a new unit. Okay. Not new unit, the continuation, roots I was talking about. So till the, we have three more minutes to start the timing for 9:30. So I'll give you a few questions you can answer to me. Okay. Who is this Akanksh? Akanksh, have you seen the previous videos? This is your first class, I can understand. Have you seen the previous videos which we have done? They might have sent you the link, right? Akanksh? Akanksh is boy, eh? Okay, two videos you have seen. Okay, good. You are boy? Okay, fine. Okay, then. So let's now talk about the today's class. Little bit, I'll give you background anyway, as he's saying, he is newly coming to the class. So I'll give you just a few of the background stories, right? What all I explained in the previous class, I'll give you a few things. Then we'll start with the next one. So Akanksh, you can keep listening. Others also, like a revision, you can listen to me. Right? Previous earlier classes, whatever I have done, they were all like a bridge courses, like how much depth you have in biology that I was testing, and even some of the things I was adding up. All our students who has to come earlier and all, they know how it is. Right? It was like a bridge course, right? Bridge course in the sense from 10th, how you come to the PUC, how much you have to upgrade yourself. That was a type of story what we were doing. That is what we were dealing with in the previous classes. But from last class, I started with the syllabus directly. And the questions, what all the things we did was about the plant. We started with the morphology of flowering plants, right? So this is the syllabus. In the syllabus, like almost third unit, you get this, okay? The third part, you get the morphology of flowering plants. Flowering plants, so all of you listen to me. Flowering plants refer to those plants that will produce flower, fruits and all, right? Actually, before this, you get some of the plants which are non-flowering plants. Those will not produce the flowers. Like, they are all called the cryptogams. Do you know about the cryptogams? Cryptogams? Ah, hi, hi, blessed morning. Okay, fine. Harshit, blessed morning. You too have a blessed morning. Okay, Harshit. Dilip is saying good morning. Dilip is also first class, I think, no? Chakravarti. Is this your first class, Dilip? Hope so. Harshit, I think he was there earlier. I don't know if Dilip, I think first time I'm listening to or hearing his word. Good morning, Prakriti. Good morning. Good morning, Kirtana. Okay. Okay, so let's talk about subject, okay? Okay, don't say much after time. No, good morning, enough. I told you that in plant kingdom, there are two types of plants. Some are flowering plants, some are non-flowering plants. Flowering plants normally produce the flower with the male and female sex organs. Good morning, this is your first class. Toshita. Toshita, good. Good, it's a first class. I'm giving some background and watch and listen to me. Now I'm Likhita. Okay, Likhita, a new student. Okay, all of you new students, no worries. I'm always starting some brushing up from the previous classes. Okay, if you have seen the previous videos also. Apart from that, what is new? That I will, what was the thing what we did in the last class? Then we are going to start. Don't worry, if it is your new class also, I'll give you some background of the new, the old, little bit about the old things. Apart from that, you watch the previous videos, okay? Okay, Likhita? Okay, I hope so. Toshita also. You can listen to me, then we can start off. Okay, is it fine? Okay, fine dear. So I was talking about the chapter directly, the unit. Nandita, good morning. Okay, now what is that I told you right now? In plant kingdom, we have two groups of plants. Some are flowering plants, some are non-flowering plants. Flowering plants are normally advanced plants. Okay, but non-flowering are primitive plants. So there, just now I told you what are the non-flowering plants called as. What do you call the non-flowering plants? Two groups I told you. Flowering and non-flowering plants, what we call it? Just now you were listening, right? Those who have come just now, first class and all, not Napita and all. Those who came for the first class, you just tell me what are the flowering plants. What are the non-flowering plants called? Okay, so let me write it on the board so that you will get an idea how it is. What are the various types of plants we are dealing with? Okay, good morning, Kirtana. Let's start with the story about the plant biology. Okay, so in the whole of plants, all the plants, when you study, they are classified into two groups. First one are called non-flowering plants, called as cryptogams. Cryptogams are the non-flowering plants. Okay. Second group is called phanerogams. Phanerogams refers to the flowering plants. Okay. These are the two groups. And the cryptogams we learn, first one, the mostly algae. Second one, bryophytes. Third one, pteridophytes. So all of you, I'm just giving a background. Okay, don't worry. Those who attended last class also can listen to it, because I want to give you some background of the plants. Because most of us will not be much interested in plants. We only know about humans, because whenever I was asking you a lot of questions on the human physiology, everybody was excellently answering. But plants, most of us, we will not much bother. Okay, we'll say, okay, some plants are there. That's not required. You have to learn more, because they're ultimately source of food for us. Therefore, understand them properly. Then under phanerogams, we have first type gymnosperms. Then second type, we have angiosperms. So these are the group of plants we are learning. Cryptogams are the non-flowering. They don't have flowers, like algae if you observe. They're the filament-like structure. They're thin structure. So algae, when you observe any algae, their body is called the filament. Filament is like a small thread-like structure. They're like this. They'll grow in water. They're hydrophytic in nature. Bryophytes actually are called the thallophytes. They will have thallus-like structure, like a cushiony structure will be there, attached to the ground with the help of rhizoids. Right? This is about the bryophytes. Pteridophytes are actually called the ferns. These are the thallus-like structure. This is called a thallus. Their body is called as filament. Pteridophytes will be having the underground stem like this, and aerial leaves will be there. Okay? Like this. They are all ferns. Okay, this you have seen, and young ones are quite like this. These are the pteridophytes. These are all coming under cryptogams. Cryptogams means non-flowering plants. They are the very primitive plants. Mostly these are hydrophytic in nature. They are found in water. They are thread-like structures. Bryophytes are coming on the ground. Actually, they move from the water content, water habitat to the land habitat. But they normally will have thallus, means flat cushion-like structure grows on the surface of the water. This is for the bryophyte, and this is called the thallus. Thallus is flat, cushiony structure. Pteridophytes are called the ferns. Ferns, I hope you have seen. They'll be having aerial leaf-like structures and underground stem like this. They're usually used for your regular flower arrangement and all. Use this, right? But all of them, they grow in mainly high altitudes or in water, right? Mostly we don't see all of them in that regular plant, because they're not dominating the earth. Now come to phanerogams, they are the flowering plants. Under flowering plants, first one is called the gymnosperm. These are called as a naked seeded plants. So last class I gave this as a background. Suppose you observe the seed, there will be seed coats. Above that, there will be fruit wall. This fruit wall is called the pericarp. So this is the seed. Okay. If there is a pericarp, it is a covered seed. Seed is covered by the pericarp or the fruit wall and nourishes it. But in gymnosperms, directly on the leaves, the female flowers are grown like this. They don't have directly seed will be there. There is no fruit wall on them. Therefore, they are called as the naked seeded plants. And angiosperms are called as covered seeded plants. Okay. So, this is like a small background I have given for those who are attending first the class. Okay. Now, we are going to talk about the angiosperm morphology. Okay. Those who are coming for the first class, you just take this classification, and other students who are there now, those who are attending earlier, you make another notebook where you write the information for NEET. Okay. This is a regular class work what I am giving you. That is right. We are continuing the angiosperm morphology. But in the another one, single notebook or so, or from the last page or another 100 or 200 page notebook, you keep it. NEET information. Information for the NEET examination. So these are the most important things for the NEET, because again, we are going to deal with them separately. But right now, to understand what is angiosperm, we should know what are the previous things. Why do we call them angiosperms? Is it fine? So write them in short points, just as it is, what is on the, whatever is there on the board. Okay, fine. I hope you are right. Are you ready? Okay, I told you where you have to write. You have to take another one notebook. You maintain it for only exclusively NEET. Excess extra things, ma'am, ruled or unruled. Listen, Likhita, you can manage unruled, it's fine. If you are not able, your lines will go in a wrong way, then better you take ruled book only. Because most of the time, when you start in an unruled book, the lines will go all haphazardously. Therefore, if you are able to manage, you take unruled. Okay? One notebook for the regular class, what I am doing it. One notebook for the NEET points only. Okay? Excessive points and all, I am giving you right here. Chandrasapa, ma'am, I have not taken NEET, but I have taken biology. So, what you do? No, listen, Chandrasapa, you have not taken NEET is fine. But this is the basic background required for basic biology itself. Okay, whether I am not doing separately NEET, I am doing board syllabus. This is a background. Chandrasapa, did you understand? This is because a lot of students are there. My students are there who are your seniors. They have not taken up NEET, but still they have learned biology at the later stage. They liked it so much they took NEET also. You understand? Right now, you don't bother whether it is NEET or not. You write this as a background for biology, and it helps in detail when I do it. It helps in NEET. Okay. Right now, you maintain it in another way so that it is like a basics for biology. Do you understand, Chandrasapa? So take it as a basics, because any examination you take, basics is to be, has to be very strong. Do you understand, Chandrasapa? Okay, fine. So did you take it down? Cryptograms and phanerograms, did you write it? You write it in another notebook. Fine? Okay. Now I had started with our angiosperm morphology, right? Morphology of angiosperms, I started with giving you typical plant, which is a pure typical angiospermic plant I had given you last class, right? Okay. Fine, let's talk about the background, what we did. Okay, so I'll write just small things. Ma'am, you should give notes of what, dear Abhigna? Can you tell me which properties? Yeah, I'll first finish all that, then little background. Okay, then I'll give you the notes for that. Okay, Abhigna? Okay, keep listening to me. I'll give you all angiospermic characteristics. Then I will start. Those who come for the new class, first class also, some background I am going to give you. Is it fine? Other students can take it as little revision. Okay, did you write this all? All of you wrote this? I hope you have written it. Now, we will talk about the angiospermic typical plant of angiosperm, which you already know that typical plant will have the seed germination. When you talk about the one which grows up is a plumule, is called the plumule. This becomes shoot system. This is a radical which will become the shoot system. This is a root system. This is a shoot system. Okay. Now coming to the typical plant of dicot. So we have dicot and monocot plants, right? Dicotyledons have two cotyledons. So when you observe, the dicot plants will have the root like this, where there is a primary root, there are secondary roots, and there are tertiary roots. This is called the taproot system. This is the primary, secondary, tertiary roots. And here there will be a stem, okay? This is the stem, in short system. It has nodes and internodes. And you will find axillary buds, apical buds, and leaves you will have, right? And sometimes you get the flowers at the tip. Okay, it's an apical bud growing. Here are the buds. Here are the flowers. And here you may get the fruits. Okay, this is a typical plant of angiosperm. And dicot plants will have network like veins and veinlet arrangement. We call it as a reticulate venation. But when you study the monocot plants, you find the stem like this, more sturdy, but fibrous root, bundle of roots will grow like this. Because radical will not produce the root system. Nodes and internodes are very strong, and there will be leaves which are thin and long with the parallel venation, very important. And you may get the male and female flower separately in the form of inflorescence. And at the tip you have male inflorescence. Imagine I'm drawing the maize plant. There is a female inflorescence, okay? And here is a male inflorescence. This is a male, this is a monocot plant, that is a dicot plant. This much is a background of this, okay? So let's now move on to the root in particular, right? So root system, when I explain you, roots are of two types. One is taproot system, one is fibrous root system. Taproot is found in dicotyledonous plants, fibrous root is found in monocot plants. Coming to the dicot plants, or the root system itself when you talk about, the radical, if it produces a major root, primary root, we call it as the taproot. If radical will die and the other roots, adventitious roots grow from the lower part of the stem, it is called as the adventitious roots, or the it becomes fibrous root. Now I told you about the root modifications. The part what we started is root modifications. So what are the root modifications? The roots, apart from giving the function or helping the plant for absorption, fixation, penetration and conduction of water, they will do some other function like storage of food, or sometimes they give the mechanical support. So under this, we are learning two types. First one, storage roots. Storage roots, they help to store the food. So it's detailed, you have learned it in the previous one. Okay, those who are coming for the first class, you just go through my previous video, you will get to know. So storage roots, we have taproot modifications, first one, in which the fusiform modification, in which the upper part is thin or narrow, in middle part is woolen. This is called the fusiform, as in radish. And another one is called the conical root, in which the roots are swollen at the tip, gradually tapers towards the end, forming a conical structure. It is found in carrot. Then napiform root are those who are swollen heavily but suddenly taper towards the lower end. This is called the taproot modification under storage function. Okay. Now we are going to next one I gave you was the fibrous root modification for storage. First one I gave you, the tubular roots, where roots will be in the form of tubular, elongated tube-like, tubular roots. Okay? Or tubular, like tuberous roots as seen in sweet potato. Sweet potato. Okay? This is already done in the last class, so I'm not going to detail the explanation. Okay, do you understand? Don't think this way I'll go for all the time. No, only for this class, I'm giving the students who are coming for the first time some revision. Although you are seeing the videos, I want you to little brush up. Okay, this is a tuberous root in sweet potato. Then comes the fasciculated root. Fasciculated refers to fascicle, means bundle. They'll be found in small bundles like finger-like projections. This is a fascicle. This is seen in asparagus. Then, last one is beaded roots. They look like beads. Okay? They'll be like this. At this certain interval, they are swollen like the beads. They're called the beaded roots. These are seen in grasses. Okay? This is about the background what we have done already. Okay, is it fine? Do you understand all the newcomers? Did you get what we had done in the last class? You better see the videos to get the detailed explanation. Okay, now we are going to talk about the next part, that is which we started in the last class but did half of it, right? Those are all root modifications for storage. Now I give you root modifications for giving mechanical support. So such roots are growing above the ground. So we learn it under the heading second group, that is aerial root modification or aerial roots. Above the ground, how are they modified? So above the ground, again we have first type as mechanical roots, those who are giving extra mechanical support, right? So what are those aerial roots for mechanical support? One I gave you was this plant. This is the banyan tree. If it produces a big branches all over here, somebody should support them. Okay, these new branches, this is a big plant. Okay, this is a whole big plant. These plant, this has main root here, but these branches which are produced away from it, they will produce some adventitious roots. So what are adventitious roots? The roots that are grown other than the radical are called adventitious roots. These grow downwards and reach the ground and sometimes act like a main stem. They can replace, you have seen, no, the big banyan tree you have seen in Bangalore, where main stem is gone actually. Only what you have is the these prop roots. These are called the prop roots. Prop roots, or we call them as pillar-like roots. Okay, these roots will become thick and hard. First they'll be hanging like this, later they go to the ground, they fix the plant body and give extra additional support to the main plant body, as seen in plant banyan. Okay, banyan also you can get it, and rubber plant also you get this. Okay, so now second one I'll give you, observe all of you, this is the new thing I'm giving you now. Second type, this is the first one I told you, prop roots. Second one is called as the stilt roots. So stilt roots are seen in the plant like maize and sugarcane. Maize or sugarcane, when you observe, you can see here the main stem is like this. Okay, this is a main stem. Here we have fibrous roots from the lower part of the stem, and here are the nodes and internodes. What happens? This plant will grow so tall, thin and tall, this may lodge because it's growing thin and tall and root is not very deep. Therefore, some of the roots will grow from the lower nodal region that grow down and give the additional mechanical support. Can you make out this? These are called as the stilt roots. Even here they start growing like this. I think you have seen such roots, right? These are called stilt roots. They grow towards the ground, obliquely down, and give extra support. This is called as stilt roots. These are the stilt roots. Okay, these are the stilt roots. These are the prop roots. Okay, third one I'll give you. It is about the climbing roots. Climbing roots are seen in plant like pothos. Pothos andre money plant. Money plant you must be having, no, at home. Right now you are not going anywhere outside, grow one money plant at home. It will give at least some oxygen in your house. Okay, so coming to this, the pothos plant grow around any support. It need not be a plant support only. It may be any hard wall also it will grow, right? So maybe there is a big support here. Okay, on this support the money plant will grow like this. Okay, okay, then the leaves of money plant, you all know how they will be. They look like this. You have seen, I think, money plant, you all have seen, right? They'll grow. Even betel nut is like this. And here the roots are given to attach to the host or the substratum, not to suck or nutrients or anything. These are the climbing roots. They help to climb with us and the support. Okay. This is about the climbing roots of pothos or money plant or betel nut plant. So before I give notes to all of them, write all the three types, because this you have written already, old students. Now these two you have to add. Fine? Thank you. Are you drawing? You draw both of them, all the three diagrams. Did you write? Have you finished drawing? See, first in climbing routes, you just write it as a support. 1 minute. No, I will wait. No need to worry. I will wait. Akshara, your writing is fine. Those who are taking time, let them take time. Because initially, I will give time to you. Done? Okay. What about new students? Those who have come today, they have to draw three diagrams. Others have to draw only two diagrams. No, let them be, let's wait for them. So many new students have come. Likita's picture is nice. Good. Okay, Litika. Litika, no, not Likita. I'm sorry. Litika. Okay, good. You take time, those who have come today, other students, give them some time to draw. Okay, because they have to write three diagrams. Akanksh has written already. Litika has drawn, I think. Napita, no voice, not to be heard. Normally, Napita will be speaking very nicely all the time. Yeah, ma'am, you are there, I know, but no voice, I said. Okay, no issues. Done, Litika. Okay, what about all other students? Toshita said, yes, ma'am. Okay, fine. Okay, Jeevita, done, ma'am. Okay, done. All of you done. Okay, good. Okay, now let me write, give you points on that. Dilip Chakravarti, done. Good. Okay, write some points on this. Some introduction about this, you write. In some plants, adventitious roots grow above the ground. Adventitious roots grow above the ground. Above the ground. And help the plant body. Help the plant body. Either to give mechanical support, or vital support. Vital in the sense living functions. Okay. or vital support. Mechanical support or vital support. First, write daddy, mechanical roots. Mechanical roots. These are the type of aerial roots. These are the type of aerial roots that give extra mechanical support to the plant body, that give extra mechanical support to the plant body. Plant body. First one, prop roots. Prop roots. These are the advantageous roots. These are the advantageous roots. Produced from aerial branches of the stem. Produced from aerial branches of the stem. That grow towards ground, that grow towards ground, towards ground, comma, sometimes penetrate into the ground, sometimes penetrate into the ground. I repeat. These are the advantageous roots produced from the aerial branches of the plant. I'm repeating, produced from the aerial branches of the plant, comma, that grow towards ground. Just make a full stop. Next sentence you write. That grow towards the ground. Put on the stop. Next to right. These roots sometimes penetrate into the ground. Penetrate into the ground. Become hard. And function like the main stem. Function like the main stem. Or sometimes replace the main stem. Sometimes replace the main stem. Means they take up that work. Sometimes replace the main stem. Written. Okay. Next. As they give additional support, like pillars of the plant, pillars of the plant, they are called pillar roots. They are called pillar roots. Then, next, second one, stilt roots. Stilt roots. These are the advantageous roots. These are the adventitious roots that are produced from the lower nodal region of the stem, that are produced in the lower nodal region of the stem, comma, they grow obliquely downwards. They grow obliquely, they will not be growing straight, they will grow like this. They grow obliquely downwards. I will repeat. First, let me finish. I said these are the adventitious grown from the lower nodal region of the stem, comma. They grow obliquely downwards. I am repeating. Chandana. Obliquely downwards. Did you finish? Chandana. Okay. Obliquely downwards. Reach the ground. Reach the ground and give extra support to the stem. Next, I'll give you climbing roots, right? That is climbing roots. See the diagram. Okay, listen here. Just watch it. This is the, not a host. This is any background, either a wall or anything. It's not a host plant. Remember, this is the plant, right? Utah's plant, which is producing the roots. Okay, write down. Climbing roots are produced in plants like pothos or beetle leaf. Beetle nuttala, beetle leaf and vilayadele, beetle leaf or pepper. So many plants are there. Pepper, you know, no? Pepper, menso, tall menso, right? Pepper. Full stop. Next point. These plants show weak climbing stem. Weak climbing stem. These plants show weak climbing stem. Next point. They climb around any hard support. And attach to the support with the help of climbing roots. Attached to the support with the help of climbing roots. Understood this? Okay. So it is not going to take anything from this plant. Is it fine? You want me to repeat it? Write down. I am repeating. The plants like, sorry, this is found in the, I am repeating, climbing roots. They are found in plants like beetle leaves, pothos, and pepper. Okay, done. Next. These plants show weak climbing stem. Weak climbing stem. Done. Next. These plants climb around the support, comma, and attach to it with the help of climbing root. Attach to it with the help of climbing roots. Right? Understood? I repeated. Okay? But listen. Listen, this is not absorbing anything. It's a plant also. Any host plant is there also. It's not going to absorb nutrition from that. Only it is for the mechanical support. Okay? So is it fine? Those who wanted me to repeat, I repeated. Okay? Yes, done. So let's now talk about the next one. So next thing what I'll give you is some of the vital roots. Vital in the sense, those which are giving living support to the plant. Vital means living, right? So the second type, first one was mechanical root, this is the vital roots. Okay? Vital refers to living support to the plant. Okay. One of the example I'll just give you, understand. There are certain plants which are grown in the marshy area. Marshy andre, the land in which a lot of soil and sand are mixed with water, that becomes airproof. That's called the marshy land. Where the sea water, the river joins the sea, there the sea river will bring the soil, smooth soil, mixes with the sand and form a nice syrup. That's called the marshy land. All plants cannot grow. Only some of the mangroves will grow there. Okay. Some of the mangrove plants will grow there. Imagine that plant is there. So imagine this is the main plant. This is the main plant growing in the marshy land. This is all marsh. Okay. These roots, which are main roots, they are not getting any air and all other things. They will not get anything. Some of the roots will grow above this. Means they come out of the main root, adventitious root they grow, and they will come above this ground and they possess number of openings, pores on this. These are called as breathing roots. These are called the breathing pores what they have. These are the breathing roots. So first one I'm dealing with this is a breathing roots. It's seen in the plant Avicennia. Right? Like that, some of the roots I'm showing you, they are growing above the ground. Okay. And all around this area, you will get some roots. Okay. So with this all ground, you will get some roots like this all around. These are all breathing roots, right? Produced from the other plants also. These are called the breathing roots. And these are also called as another name is there, nematophores, in PNU, nematophores. Right? Very important word I'm giving you, nematophores, which are nothing but the breathing roots. Okay? With this help of these pores, they will breathe. They get the oxygen because they are growing in a marshy land where they are not getting any air in it. Therefore, they produce breathing type of roots. Did you understand this properly? Did you all follow this? Yeah, did you? I hope you all understood it. Okay? Second thing I'll give you. These are called as the epiphytic roots. Epiphytic roots. Right? This is found in plants like orchids like Vanda. Vanda is one of the name of an orchid. Orchids you have seen, I think. Right? These orchids are very small plants. Small, small, this much. Hardly 4 to 5 inches or so. But small, small ones. Right? A few centimeters also. Maybe. Right? These plants are growing only in the high moisture environment, humid condition. Right? Humid condition, and they'll be found in the tropical forests. Tropical evergreen forest means very thick forest it is. Right? In those forests, you can see big, big taller trees from the first canopy. Big canopy, thick canopy is there. So for these small plants grow under the ground, they will not get light also. Right? If you have gone, anybody go to trekking, anybody go to trekking? Let me ask you first about this. Anybody go for trekking in any forest land and all you have gone? Yes, ma'am. Somebody is saying yes, ma'am. Good. Napita is saying no. Napita is only bookish, I think. Na? Napita, you should do all that. Right? Yes, ma'am. So many are saying yes, ma'am. Okay? One is saying Akshara is saying she yes. Avigna is saying yes. Yeah, Manisha is saying yes. Very good. All are very, very. Ma'am, spelling of the example. I'll give you, baby. I'll give you the spelling. First, you listen. I had gone. Where you had gone, Chanpasappa? Dilip. Napita, okay, ma'am. What? Okay, ma'am. You start doing all little activities. Because that will give you some extra moral support. Lonavala. Okay, very good. Lonavala is in near Mumbai, right? Okay, I think Mumbai. Okay. Chanpasappa is saying, yeah. No, Lonavala, I know. I've heard about it. Okay. So first you write this, then we'll go to the other example. Okay. First you write the heading vital roots. B. Draw the diagram. I'll give you the spelling properly. Write the heading vital roots. First one is breathing roots. Okay. Draw it. In between, you tell me other people, they said yes, where had I been to trekking? Other students. All of you keep drawing this diagram. Where and all you are gone? Elle hogi bandidira? Outskirts of Bangalore is nothing yet. Outskirts of Bangalore, there is no trekking. Edakkal Caves. Okay, why not? Okay, that's good. Edakkal Caves. Living in Lonavala, ma'am, living in Lonavala also have gone working to treat me. Other than Lonavala, na? Okay, good. Mangalore near Ashwathpura, ma'am. Okay, a forest near Hebbay Falls. Okay, that's very good. Actually, Hebbay Falls is with school people, I think. School friends, eh? Gokarna. Okay, good. ಇದ್ಯಾವುದು ಅಹೋಬಿಲಂ ರಾಮನಗರ ರಾಮನಗರದಲ್ಲಿ ಇದ್ದಿದ್ಯಾ ಐದು ಮೂಡಿಗೆರೆ ಐದು ಮೂಡಿಗೆರೆ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿದೆ ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಐ ಸೇ ಮೂಡಿಗೆರೆ ಮನಾಲಿ ಮನಾಲಿ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ ವೆರಿ ಗುಡ್ ಚನ್ಬಸಪ್ಪ ಇಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಂಗ್ ಫಿಲ್ ನಿಯರ್ ದ ರೆಸಾರ್ಟ್ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್ ನಿಯರ್ ಎ ರೆಸಾರ್ಟ್ ವೇರ್ ನಿಯರ್ ರೆಸಾರ್ಟ್ ಐ ಡೋಂಟ್ ನೋ ದಿಯರ್ ಓಕೆ ಐ ಡೋಂಟ್ ನೋ ಎನಿ ನಿಯರ್ ಬೈ ಬೆಂಗಳೂರ್ ಐ ಸೀನ್ ಹಾರ್ಲಿ ಎನಿ ಫಾರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಶಿವಮೊಗ್ಗ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಯಾ ಕೆಮಲ್ ಗುಂಡಿ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಇದೆ ಕುದುರೆಮುಖದಲ್ಲಿ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿದೆ ಕೊಡೈಕೆನಾಲ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇದೆ ಶಿವಮೊಗ್ಗ ಹಿಲ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ ಹೋಗ್ಬೋದು ಫಾರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಬಟ್ ಎನಿವೇ ಫಾರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಂಗ್ ಟ್ರೆಕ್ಕಿಂಗ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು ಸುಮ್ಮನೆ ಹೋಗಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಪಿಕ್ನಿಕ್ ಮಾಡೋದಲ್ಲ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಮಧುಗಿರಿ ಹಿಲ್ಸ್ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿದೆ ಬಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲೆಲ್ಲ ವಾಕ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು ನೀವು ಕಾರಲ್ಲಿ ಜೀಪಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಗಿದ್ರೆ ಪ್ರಯೋಜನ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅದು ಟ್ರೆಕ್ಕಿಂಗ್ ಅನ್ನಲ್ಲ ಮಾದೇಶ್ವರ ಬೆಟ್ಟ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾದೇಶ್ವರ ಹಿಲ್ಸ್ ಕೇವ್ ಹಿಲ್ ಇನ್ ಯುಪಿ ವೆರಿ ಗುಡ್ ರೋಹನ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಯುಪಿಯಾ ಓಕೆ ರೋಹನ್ ಇಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಬೆಂಗಳೂರು ಹಿಲ್ ಬಟ್ ಹಿ ಹಸ್ ಗೋನ್ ಟು ಯುಪಿ ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಫಿನಿಶ್ ಡ್ರಾಯಿಂಗ್ ಆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಯು ಐ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಗಿವ್ ಯು ನೋಟ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ದೆನ್ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಅಪ್ ವಿತ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಟೋರಿ ಓಕೆ So you have to learn biology along with all this nature. You have to live in nature. Or you have to visit nature. Not now. After the corona thing and all get over, you start doing. Okay. Then. All of you done? Okay. You have finished that thing. Okay. Write on the first one. Breathing. Write the heading vital roots. Write one or two points for intro. See any... chapter you start you just give small introduction right if you don't give introduction there's no meaning for that right if I ask you why I'm asking all this because I'm getting introduced to you and you are getting introduced to me always any answer you write it's a very nice thing that you should give some introduction okay ma'am what is the word next to breathing roots ah northern rama yavu kelta idya have you seen ya kada Name of the example is Abyssinia. I write once again. My handwriting is not that beautiful. A-V-I-C-I-N-N-I-A. Abyssinia. Another example, you write Rhizophora. Both are the example. Examples for the breathing roots. This is the breathing pore. These are the breathing roots. ಬ್ರೀದಿಂಗ್ ರೂಟ್ಸ್ ಇದು, ಇದು ಬ್ರೀದಿಂಗ್ ಪೋರ್ ಇದು. ಒಂದೊಂದು ಹೋಲ್ಗೆ ಬ್ರೀದಿಂಗ್ ಪೋರ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ. ಗೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತು ಮೀನಿಂಗ್ ವಿಸೀಮಿಯ ಸ್ಪೆಲ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ಗೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತಾ? ಓಕೆ ಡನ್. ಓಕೆ ಫೈನ್. ಓಕೆ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ರೈಟ್ ವೈಟಲ್ ರೂಟ್ಸ್. These are the adventitious roots. These are the adventitious roots. That grow aerially and give vital support. Vital support, that is living support to the plant. Vital support or living support to the plant. Then, first one, breathing roots are nematophores. Spelling of the nematophores, Napita? Nematophores, PNEO. ಎಕ್ಸಾಮ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಎನ್ಇ ಅಂತ ಬರೆಯಂಗಿಲ್ಲ, ನಿಮೆಟಾಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಪಿ ಎನ್ ಇ ಯು. ಎನಿ ಅದರ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ಸಚ್ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ವಿತ್ ಪಿ ಎನ್? ನ್ಯುಮೋನಿಯಾ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ವಿತ್ ಪಿ ಎನ್, ರೈಟ್? ಸೋ ಮೆನಿ ಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ಪಿ ಇಸ್ ಸೈಲೆಂಟ್, ರೈಟ್? ಸೈಕಾಲಜಿ ಪಿ ಇಸ್ ಸೈಲೆಂಟ್ ಹಂಗೆ. ಓಕೆ, ನಿಮೆಟಾಫೋರ್ಸ್, ರೈಟ್? ಇನ್ plants that grow in marshy land, the bracket mangroves, mangroves, bracket complete. The plants that grow in marshy land, the bracket mangroves, the soil is mixed with water and sand, and lack air in it, Okay? Next. Some advantageous roots. Grow above the ground. Some advantageous roots. ADVE. NTIOUS, adventitious roots. Some adventitious roots grow above the ground. I repeat it, Dilip. Grow above the ground. That possess number of pores, P-O-R-E-S, pores. With which they breathe. Number of pores with which they breathe. Thus they are called breathing roots. This is the most important question for PU board exam also or in any other competitive exam. Okay? NEET exam and all, they are asking this question many a time. Sometimes they give the drawing also. Drawing, they will ask you which is this plant or which are the roots found in mangrove plants. Is it fine? So whenever I say points are asked, you just there only you write some points, make star and write that it is for NEET. Right? Then, okay, fine. So let's now move on to the epiphytic roots. So why I told you about epiphytic roots is about your trekking I asked you, because these orchids, anybody have seen orchid plants in nature? Directly you'll get it for flower arrangement or not, you pay some money and you'll get it. What about this? Okay, Napitha has seen, where you have seen Napitha? Napitha. Where you have seen? Orchids you have seen? Directly flowers or you have seen the plants? I had been to a resort. Okay, resort and everything. Those people who said no, they do trekking and all, they would have seen. In nature. You see, in nature. Okay. Why I asked you about this? Listen. These plants are very small. I told you hardly a few inches. Centimeter or inches. Inch or maximum. Okay. And they grow in the tropical forest. Tropical forest, you would have heard, very thick there. Evergreen forest there. Thick in nature. No light also penetrates. If you go there for trekking, you don't even know whether it is day or night. So dark it is inside, right? Those who have gone for trek, they will know it, right? So dark, it's almost like darkness inside, right? Then, if these small plants grow in those thick canopy is so big, huge, few meters, and if these grow down in the ground, they will not get either light, nothing they will get. Not only white flower chanvasapa, all colors of orchids are considered to be very beautiful flowered plants. Not only a white flower, some of them are, they are like a bird, looking like a bird and all. They are all beautiful colors actually. It's a very beautiful colored plant, flower. Anybody have seen that one plant? Really, all those are in my National Geographic Discovery, all orchids, not only white flowers. White flowers over there. I'm talking about orchids are very beautiful, known for the beautiful flowers. Okay. Flower arrangement educate me. Right? Now, if these plants growing in the ground, they will not get light. What they do is very nice adaptation. Their seeds will fly in air and they will get attached or they will produce in the branches of the taller trees, big tall trees, branches will be like this, in that they start growing. Okay. I'll just show you the diagram, you will understand it. Okay. Now listen, how was the diagram of that? So let me give you how the plant looks like. Epiphytic roots I'm giving you. This is done, right? So this second one also is a vital root only, but it is called epiphytic root, right? So imagine this is the big plant. Okay, it is a branch of, just a minute, I'll just draw below. This is a branch, imagine this is a branch. In this area, the epiphytic plants of the vanda and other epiphytes, orchids will grow. This is their stem. Stem is somewhat like this, hard. And the aerial leaves will be like this. They'll be like this. They'll be thick and fleshy. These are the aerial leaves. Okay? These are the orchid leaves they have. But they have to attach to this, no? They will produce small, small roots. These are called as clinging roots. Cling and they to attach. This is one type. They are only attaching ones. They are called as clinging roots. This is a host plant. They will not harm the host plant. Instead, they will cling to the host because bigger tree, this is a host tree it is. Only three plants there, right? But this plant, let me draw properly the leaves. They'll be very thick-leaved plants, right? So the plants are like this, thick ones. Okay. They'll be very thick like this. They look like this. So these are the clinging roots. Apart from that, they produce some roots that are white in color. They hang freely in the air like this. Thick, fleshy roots will grow above the ground from this plant. They hang freely in the air. Did you get it? These are having small, small openings also, holes also. There'll be, these are called as the hanging roots. Hanging means they hang, right? Hanging roots. Now, what is speciality of hanging roots? So these hanging roots are actually cottony in color, cottony looks. They look like cotton. Means white cottony thread-like thing. Then they will contain one special tissue called as velamen. Understand this? Velamen is a special, this is a very important question to be asked in NEET and board everywhere. So velamen is a type of tissue that is light green in color, contain chloroplasts, help in photosynthesis, but main function of hanging roots is to absorb the moisture from the environment, because they can't grow as they're growing above the taller trees. It's a big tree. If they're growing on the taller trees, how can they get water? And they don't even penetrate the host. So what they do is they produce such cottony type of roots in air. They suck the moisture from the humid environment. From the humid environment, they suck the moisture. These are called the hanging roots. Important tissue is velamen tissue. This tissue will help in photosynthesis and also it helps in absorbing moisture from the environment. Did you get this? The most important thing, one by one, I'm giving you. Each one is very important thing for you. This is the epiphytic root. Did you understand this? Did you follow, Kapita? What is that I'm saying? Yes. So now you draw this diagram, right? They're adding epiphytic roots. Example, vanda or orchids. Draw it. Many roots, such ones you should draw. Not too thick, not too thin also. They are not very like thin, like thread-like thing. They'll be slightly thick. Okay? And here also. Hang with them. From the main plant there. Okay, done. Right. The main plant which is there now, you can just darken that. The main plant. Or else leave it. You will not see what is the real plant. Okay. The host plant you just leave as it is. Are you drawing? Are Dilip, so fast you don't do draw happily. When I'm drawing, you don't have to draw. When I'm drawing, you listen and observe how I'm drawing. Don't finish fast. There is nothing, no marks for fast drawing. You're done, all of you? I don't know, you people, if you are not taking finishing earlier also no issue, but draw it properly. Did you label all of them? Clinging roots, host plant, hanging roots. Written. And this is the stem, and these are the leaves of the orchid plant. This, right? Stem. These are the leaves. This is the stem. Right on, ma'am. Hanging absorb nutrients. No, nutrients where are available, Dilip? In air, nutrients are available. I don't know. In air, you will not get nutrients. No, nutrients are producing through the leaves. They leaves are doing photosynthesis that produce food. Nutrients will be available only in the leaves they produce. Got it? Write down epiphytic roots. These are a type of vital roots. These are a type of vital roots. That normally help to absorb what moisture from environment. That normally help to absorb moisture from the environment. And take part in photosynthesis. And take part in photosynthesis. Next, right? Most of the orchids grow in the tropical forests next. They normally grow in the branches of taller trees. Two minutes, huh? Akshara, you want time to draw? Okay, I'll wait. Okay, I will wait for you to draw. Done, huh? Okay. What I said? They often grow in the branches of taller trees. Next. Okay, later you ask for the Likita. Okay, you ask for the recorded version, okay, you can go, but don't do this as a habit, okay? Later you'll be suffering, see. Okay, fine, no issues, okay. Take permission from sir and get the recorded version of this. Okay, right. Next, write down. Grow in the branches of taller trees. Written now. Next. The plant attaches to the host with the help of small clinging roots. Attaches to the host with the help of small clinging roots. Clinging roots. Next. Third reading, right? Hanging roots. These are slightly thick, fleshy. These are slightly thick, fleshy. Cottony roots. Cottony and the cotton like. Cottony roots. These are slightly thick, fleshy and cottony roots. I repeat. These are thick, fleshy, cottony roots. Hanging roots you are writing. Toshita. They are thick, fleshy, cottony roots that hang freely in air. That hang freely in air. I'll stop. They possess a special tissue. They possess a special tissue. What is the tissue? Special tissue. Come on, answer. Velamen. Good, good. They possess a special tissue. Dash. Velamen tissue. Good. Correct. Velamen tissue. That contain chloroplasts and is spongy in nature. Chloroplast and is spongy in nature. Next, velamen tissue helps him. Velamen tissue helps him. Helps in photosynthesis and absorption of moisture from environment. Photosynthesis and absorption of moisture from environment. Then okay, so you have learned this. Now I'll go to the next one. See here, host is not harmed. Because one point, very last word, right in the bracket. Host plant is not harmed. In the bracket, right? Host plant is not harmed. Comma. The plants that depend upon another plant only for attachment not for nourishment. Only for attachment, not for nourishment, are called epiphytes. I repeat, the plants that depend on the host plant only for attachment and not for nourishment. And not for nourishment are called epiphytes. Written means it is present on the host but not doing anything else. Just staying there, attachment. Nothing else it wants from the host plant. Done? Good. Okay. Now I'll give you one of the plant which is attaching and sucking the nutrition from the host. We call them as parasites. Okay. The difference you can understand very easily. This is attaching to the host, but nothing it is absorbing. But another plant I'll give you, that's called the parasitic plant, that will attach and draw the nutrients. Next will be that. Okay. Okay. So in this you can see that they are attached. Nothing it is absorbing, sucking from the host plant. Therefore, they are called epiphytes. Okay. Now I'll give you something that is called the parasitic plant or parasitic roots. These are all epiphytic roots. Now I'm giving you parasitic roots. I think third one. Parasitic roots. Okay. See how it is differing from that. You will understand only when I explain you with the diagram. Okay. So imagine there is one plant here. This is a host plant. Okay. This is attached to the ground. Right. This plant is big one. Okay. There will be another parasite growing on this. Like this. It's a parasite. It is having this root system. Like this. Now, this parasite will produce the leaves. Like this. This is the parasitic leaves, parasitic plant leaves. And they produce the roots that will enter deep into the host plant. This is deeper into the host plant. They are producing the roots. These are the parasitic roots. This is the host plant. This is the host plant. It's not just any host. It's a plant. This is a parasitic plant. Plant and these are the parasitic leaves. Okay. Now, how do you understand they are the ones which are parasites on this? They look like climbing roots only, right? So for that, you have to do is you have to take the section of the host. Transverse section of host stem. If you observe the host stem, I'm taking the transection, right? I've taken the transection, cut and sliced, right? This is a host plant. This is a host plant. Its host will have number of vascular tissues. Vascular tissues, you should know that xylem and phloem are the vascular tissues. The one present inside is the xylem, one that is present outside is the phloem. These are the vascular bundles. These are the vascular bundles of the host, where the water and food, that is, food is supplied or transported through phloem. This is phloem. This is the xylem in the host. Now, what happens is our parasitic roots will enter here up to certain stage, and very cleverly they will form number of small finger-like outgrowths that will suck the nutrition. These are the parasitic roots. Parasitic root it is. And these finger-like projections are there. They are called as the haustoria. Hope you got the meaning. H-A-U. Haustoria is nothing but the finger-like projections of the parasitic roots that enter into the sea. Xylem and phloem, it is entering. Xylem is a water conducting tissue and food connective tissue is phloem. Right? It is entering in both of them, they are getting the nutrition from that. Therefore, this is not simple climbing. It looks climbing. But when you take the section of the host stem, you can see that it's not just externally attached. It has gone into the food and water conducting tissues and sucking the nutrition from the host. So many times they may kill the host plant, but actually parasites are very clever. They'll not be bigger than the host. They'll be very small, right? They want the host to be alive, right? They have to survive, no? If I'm a parasite, I'm sucking somebody's things, then I have to keep that also alive. Otherwise, if it dies, I will also get killed. The same thing, parasitic plants are so clever, they will be very small first of all. Then they will be sucking nutrition slowly so that the host will not be killed, but it is providing nutrition. This is how it's called the host-parasitic relationship. If they kill it, parasite also is killed. Do you understand this? So this is a very important type of plant which is seen in the plant like example I'm giving you, Cuscuta. Cuscuta is one example, another one is Loranthus. There are two examples I'm giving you. One is Cuscuta, one is Loranthus. Do you understand this? You can ask me doubts in this. Any doubts are there in this? Ma'am, does it come under the aerial underground? The under aerial roots. Yes. It is under, see, main plant is above the ground, no? Srishti. Does this harm? Yes, I don't know. Just now, can my supply, it may little bit harm, but it is not going to kill the host. No doubts, huh? Okay, good. Ma'am, will the host plant not identify? Are you, Papa Chay doesn't know. Plants don't have that big nervous system. Humans are there. If you have a roundworm in your stomach, how do you identify? It will be pain. But still, they are growing, na? That's why. That too, plants can't help it. They don't know. A lot of things will grow on them. Abhigna. Okay? Draw, write the heading parasitic roots. Good. Napita has no doubts at all. Very good. She knows a lot of things. That's nice. But still, learn the botanical part very nicely. Because botany portions is the first thing which our students normally don't like. But you don't do that. Parasitic roots. Roots. Draw them. You love botany too, na? Very good, Napita. That's nice. Grow small, small plants. Anyway, you are free. Take any plastic part, pots and all, start growing. Have you started growing? If nothing is there, you just grow some methi and pudina and all. Pudina and all, cut parts, you can grow. And even in the palak, can cut the roots and roots, you can grow them. You are growing pudina. But you can grow coriander also. Coriander, methi and all, you grow. Okay? It's easy to grow. First of all, waste buckets and all will be there. In that, you put little soil and start it. Plant don't want anything. Just some soil, some water, some light. Okay? Good. That's good. Are you drawing? Ma'am, what is TS of host stem? Transverse section. Akshara, transverse section. Means you cut transversely. ಹೋಸ್ಟ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್, ಹೋಸ್ಟ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ ಇರ್ತಲ್ಲ ಅದರ ಸ್ಟೆಮ್ ನ ಕಟ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. Finished? Okay. Right on. Parasitic roots. Parasitic roots. Are a type of vital roots, are a type of vital roots that grow in parasitic plants parasitic plants that can suck the nutrients and water from the host plant Next point, you write. In plants like Cuscuta and Loranthus, stem is very weak. And it climbs around the host plant. Climbs around the host plant Next. Parasitic plant produce parasitic roots. Parasitic plants produce parasitic roots. That penetrate into the vascular tissues of host plant. Next point. Parasitic roots penetrate into the host plant stem, produce number of finger-like outgrowths. Called hostoria. I hope you know the spelling. Hostoria. H-A-U-S-T-O-R-I-A. Hostoria. I repeat. Parasitic roots enter the host stem. And produce number of finger-like outgrowths. Called Haustoria. H-A-U-S-T-O-R-I-A. Haustoria. I hope you are drawn, no? Labeled, I think, Haustoria. Haustoria. That enter the xylem and phloem of host. And draw food and water from it. Then, finish drawing, all of you. Examples also you have written. Skanda, your video is on. I am observing you. Skanda, are you listening? Good. Okay, fine, dear students. So we are going to wind up here because it's already 1 o'clock. I'm sorry, 11 o'clock. We have to stop it. Right? So we are going to meet again. All the days we are meeting till Friday. Okay? We'll finish a lot of classes, a lot of portions now. Okay? So be punctual. Be ready. Have all the points with you. Note them down clearly. Get some highlighter pens. Whenever I need to know, you add them there. And underline them nice, the neat points. Or important points on the board, I'll give 1 mark, 2 mark questions, everything you have to do it, right? So you will be preparing well. Well, you know our students are doing very well in the main exam also. So you will be always doing for the good thing, right? You're all growing well, right? You're all intelligent. Okay, see you then. Very good. Have a nice day. Enjoy. See you, bye. Thanks, Manisha. Thanks. Thank you, Akshara. Dilip. Where is Skanda? Skanda, I was seeing. Skanda, are you there? Dear Skanda. Skanda, gone, huh? Okay, bye then. Bye, Jevita. Bye. Sri Raksha Chandana. Dilip, bye. Have a nice day. See you.